November 26, 2002, Pomona, California, The Glasshouse with some 41. Matsy and James are now the final two members of the troupe to fall to the flashlight plague. James is incapacitated by illness, so I start out in the driver's seat for the trip to Pomona. I'm not the best driver in the world, but my most obvious flaw is overcautiousness, which makes it easy for everyone else to sleep. The transition from Arizona to California is eerie because at the border it goes from arid desert terrain to lush, however forced, greenery. On the way we drive through a field of giant windmills that looks like something from Star Wars. They're huge and they just sort of stare down at you as you pass. Pomona seems like a nice little town and the venue tonight is the biggest that we've played on the whole tour so far. We're reunited with the some guys tonight and they tell us that Mad TV was fun. They did a skit where they play nerds on a game show, it's airing on December 7th. Their record came out today, so there's excitement in the air. Dave, Brown Sound, tells me that it's already been banned in Manitoba because of the DVD content, something about Cone getting a bottle up the ass. Marcy, Allison and a couple of people from the label are here tonight and there are about 700 people in the crowd, so it promises to be a fun one. Unfortunately things don't start out so hot. Matsy comes backstage to tell us it's time, so walk up on stage, trying to be all cool, and put our guitars on. Mike turns his on, and nothing. He turns around, checks his cables, turns the amp on again, checks his pedal, and still nothing. We've now been standing on stage for what seems like a lifetime and Mike's starting to get a little frantic. I'm starting to hear some heckles from the crowd, so it's getting harder to keep our cool and act like nothing's wrong. I feel a bit like burying myself in sand. Finally Mike finds the problem and I hear the beautiful sound of feedback pouring out of his cabinet. We're ready to roll. To make up for our pathetic intro we try to rock a little harder and by the end the crowd is getting into it and everything's okay. My version of Woe Man leaves a little to be desired, but besides that it's fine. After the show we go backstage, which some 41 is graciously sharing with us, and meet and greet new and old faces. A fight breaks out between some punker guy and someone from the second band, but it doesn't last long enough to disrupt or entertain. Some 41 rips it in front of the big crowd and shows everyone why they're stars. While we're loading out in the street after the show, some girl tells me that she loves my accent. Accent?
I don't have an accent.
We decide to stay in LA tonight, so we make the 30-minute drive into the city, stopping for a round of legendary In-N-Out burgers. Phil gets mad at Matsy because he's not as impressed with the burgers as we've made them out to be, but besides that it feels great to be back in our home away from home.